One, Jackson County Executive Mike Sanders says a local landmark is in jeopardy.
And he's declaring a public emergency to fix it. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney live at the historic Truman Courthouse on the Independence Square. Michael, what's the problem?
The problem is the building behind me, Jim. Engineers say that water has been leaking into the foundation for so long that it is now jeopardizing the building. Take a look for yourself.
Through the years, water damage has washed away portions of walls. In fact, you can see where it comes in. They call it the waterfall.
It runs right down that whole wall right there, just like a waterfall. It's penetrating that wall somehow, I'd say.
Some think it started back in the 1970s when the courthouse got a new brick exterior, but they left a gap between the old and the new.
Those walls act like the walls of a bathtub. It retains the water, which has ultimately deteriorated our foundation. Those walls have to come down.
So Sanders declared this courthouse situation a public emergency. And that allows the county to use some of its emergency fund for the $500,000 to $800,000 repair job.
If we don't act, we are in danger of effectively losing the building that we stand in here today.
But there's a catch. The money to make these repairs must be repaid to the emergency fund by the end of the year. So state lawmakers Gary Duesenberg and Victor Callahan say they will try to get the money from the state legislature. Now, the heart of this building dates back to the mid-1800s, and former President Harry Truman was a Jackson County official when it was renovated into its present form in 1933.
It's very, very important not only to the state of Missouri and the people of the state of Missouri, but to our nation, because our president, President Truman, came from here, obviously.
Now, Sanders says that he hopes to start the restoration of this foundation in the spring. He also says if they don't get the money from the state legislature, then he might go to Washington and see if he can get it included in that stimulus bill that everybody's got their hands out for. In Independence, Michael Mahoney, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. And Jackson County thought that it had the state money to make those repairs last year, but Governor Blunt vetoed that bill.